Hello everyone, myself Yamuna Poigail. Welcome to Yamuna's Physics. Today we are going to discuss a very important area known as electric field on the axial point of an electric dipole. In the previous video, we have discussed nearly two things regarding an electric dipole. What is electric dipole and also electric dipole moment. Just recap of the two points. Electric dipole is simply two equal and opposite charges at a small separation. So here we have a charge at A, another charge at B. They are equal and opposite, and the separation between the two is 2A. That is known as an electric dipole. And also one more point, electric dipole moment. It is given by P bar. It is equal to 2A times Q into P cap. The very important word, P cap. P cap is a unit vector which denotes the direction of P bar, and it is from minus Q to plus Q. Here this is the charge minus Q situated at A, the charge at B is plus Q. So the direction is from A to B. A to B, the direction is given as P cap, which is the direction of electric dipole moment. So these two informations are mandatory for us to listen to this particular topic. So let us see, we have an electric dipole of length 2A with the center O. Q is a point at a distance R from the center on the axis. So this is the center, this is the point Q where you have to find the electric field. So that's a question. Question is, find the electric field at the point Q. Clear? So that's the axial point, hence we write E axial. So this is what you're going to find out. E axial, whose value is 2 p bar by 4 pi epsilon naught r cube. How do you get it? Very simple two steps. First, find out what is the electric field at Q due to minus Q. Minus Q means this is the minus Q charge. What is the electric field at Q due to minus Q? You know, to find electric field at the point Q, we place a unit test charge at Q. So place a unit positive charge at that point, it attracts minus Q. So the direction of E minus Q is towards right, that is along P cap. So the value is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R square. What is R? The distance between that particular A and Q, that is the charge minus Q to the point Q. That is total distances from the center R. This much is A, so we can cut A, so you will have R minus A the whole square along P cap. Now what about E plus Q? E plus Q is at a distance R plus A from Q. So the answer is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q divided by R plus A the whole square. But this is a positive charge, this is a positive charge, so it repels. So what's the direction of E minus Q? Minus P cap. Now one more thing, just look at the arrows. This has a bigger length, this has a smaller length, showing that magnitude of E minus Q is much greater than that of E plus Q. Just because, look at the equation, this is R minus A at the denominator. Means, if this is small, this is higher value. The reverse, here R plus A is much bigger value, so E plus Q will be a bigger value. So from this figure, it's very clear, when this is big, this is small, this is small, this is big. So E minus Q is much greater than E plus Q. So here you have a bigger arrow, here you have a smaller arrow. Now for example, at the point Q, you have two charges, two fields, one in this direction, the other one is opposite direction. So take an example, if it is plus 7 units towards right, and if it is minus 5 units towards left, assume this is a tug of war. Suppose this is a tug of war. Who will win the war? Very simple, the person with greater strength or greater might. So here, who is the person with greater strength? E minus Q is plus 7, the other person is minus 5. So he will be winning by how much units? Plus 2 units. Plus 2 units means 2 units towards the right. So the net electric field will be, in which direction? In the direction right, because the answer is 2 p bar by 4 pi epsilon r cube. And what is p cap? P cap I told you. What is p cap? Sorry, p bar 2aq by p cap. What is the direction of p cap? Towards right. And how you get the simplified value? Just simplification in the side. How to simplify it? How to simplify? Write e minus q, e plus q, add them. So you are taking the common terms outside. Q p cap by 4 epsilon 0 common you are taking outside. In the first term you have 1 by r minus a, so you write it here. The other term you have 1 by r plus a, write it here. The minus sign comes from this term. You have taken p cap outside, so here you have taken p cap outside, here p cap outside with a minus sign. So minus sign inside, you take the LCM, r minus a the whole square, r plus a the whole square. Cross multiplying, you will get r plus a here, r minus a here. So this is of the form a plus b the whole square minus a minus b the whole square. When you cut, you will get it as 2ar here, 2ar here. Total, you will get it as 4ar. 4ar, I write in the two manner, 1 2a here, 2r here. But this all together, all those things I told you here, this thing. This is together known as P bar. This is P bar. I told you P bar is 2aq P cap. So 2aq P cap is P bar. And 2 it is written there. Here you have an R cube. How come the R cube? That's a question. It's very simple. You know R is much greater than A. What is R? R is the distance from Q to O. Compared to A, R is much higher value. So you will have the denominator as a square is neglected, a being very small value. So the denominator becomes r square whole square. R square whole square means r to the power 4. One of the powers cancel with this r. So the remaining you will have r cube at the denominator. So what's the answer? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, 2 p bar. Don't forget the par, p bar. P bar by r cube. And what p bar shows? This p bar shows that p cap. What is p cap? Electric field is towards right. So at the point Q, the electric field is in the direction of p bar. Electric field is in the direction of p bar. Hope it is clear. You have to write down these things. It's very important for the exam side. So you can write down along with me and just listen. If you have some doubts, please post it at comments. Thank you for listening. Thank you.